I need your eyes, my friend. Best not to draw attention here. I'm on the right track. That keep is well protected.
Besides, we ain't got it too rough. We can hunt in the wolds of Lindsay and whore in Botolston.
Too right. I'm done with idle time.
Grab some ale and let's skin some animals later.
Prepared. Shall we begin the washing? Hey, who comes? Welcome, stranger. Are you here to pay tribute to our Lord Alderman?
Your Alderman is long past the days of good conversation.
Yet still, he makes good company. I've been instructed to wash and prepare his earthly vessel.
Instructed by whom?
Soldiers. They brought him here as he protested, feebly. I did my best to make him comfortable, until he slipped away.
Hunwald deserves to know the truth about his father's fate. He is owed an inheritance, and deserves a chance to become Elderman himself.
All in good time, I imagine.
No, now.
When the guards put him in my care, I was told to keep all this a secret. Until the appointed time. When I asked who gave these orders, they struck me. I wish I could say more.
I've seen all I need to. but Hunwald will need proof.
Of course. You're welcome to search through his effects, though I'm not sure what trinket would best serve your purpose.
I'll find something. I don't know what this is, and I'd rather not ask.
Yes, I thought the same. Troubling.
Foul rat droppings everywhere.
Even in death, my lord is a friend to all of God's creatures.
Dried herbs and berries crushed into powder.
The time between my lord's departure and his burial is longer than usual. My lord must keep up appearances for his upcoming rites.
A box of musty clothing and a brooch with a crest. The house of the ferocious swan. This will do. I'll return this brooch to Hunwald and Lincoln. I hope the poor boy can withstand such ill news.
Eivor! What news?
Your father's dead.
Wait, what?
The sigil of Humbjord's house. I found it near his body.
No. No, this cannot be. He was strong, a pillar of Lincolnscire. He cannot be gone.
Oh, you poor boy. I'm so, so sorry.
I am a man, Archer! Do you hear me? I am a man, and I am my father's son! Do not forget it!
He's been dead for some time. That was obvious by the state of his corpse. One of you knows more than you're letting on.
I'm sorry, Hunwald. I had already asked a priest to administer last rites when your father disappeared.
What?
I didn't tell you sooner because I thought by some miracle he had survived.
You lied to me!
You silly, sobbing mooncalf. Will you never grow up?
Lord, have mercy on that woman. She should have said something. It was her duty to say something.
Hunwald was the son of an elderman. Will he take his father's seat?
The title's not hereditary, but he can plead his case before a shire moot. King Ceolwulf must then ratify the decision.
Explain how this works, your shire moot.
A moot is a meeting of lords. We convene from time to time to steer the course of our shire.
It was always my intention to convene a moot, but between our troubles in Lincoln and the bandits' raids, we slipped into a pattern of convenience.
Someone in the shire wants Hunwald dead. If I have to assemble an army to make sure this meeting is not an ambush, I will.
The Shire Moot is a lawful, godly assembly. Hunwald will be safe, as will you be.
Apart from Hunwald, who else will stand for the ultimate seat?
If I may be so bold, I should like to put my name forward. Under my care, this Shire has found some peace this past month.
I will offer my name as well. My family has ancient ties to this land. And I am proud to say I have forged quite a friendship with the Danes to the north.
Good. My priests will spread word of the moot across the Shire, and we'll convene in a few days' time.
Do visit my estate, Eivor. I have something for you. Something I think you'll enjoy.
I'll find the time.
Eivor, a word if you don't mind.
Is the word Christ or pagan?
Oh, I deeply regret my churlish ways when we first met. I did not treat you as my God commands, with kindness and love.
Love is a difficult feeling to command.
Yes, quite. In any case, thank you for putting this mystery to rest. I do hope we'll see you at the moot.
With Hunbjorth's death an open secret, Hunwald's enemies may strike again. I should find him before they do.
Archer went to console him. I should follow her.
Best of luck at the coming Shire moot, Bishop.
I would tell you my fate is in the hands of our Lord, but somehow I believe that won't be the whole story.
You fear something?
I fear everything these days, in small doses.
Archer, where is Hunwald?
I tried to console him, but he pushed me away. I love the boy, I do. But I fear what would happen if he took his father's title. He's fragile and scattered. I saw him ride north, following the paved Roman road, to the old tall tree where he often passed time with his father, I imagine.
What devil put you up to all this deception?
I wasn't put up, Eivor. I felt compelled to carry on for the good of the Shire. Until I knew the truth.
A pretty answer for an ugly lie. Aid me, be my eyes.
These woods, father. Oh, these woods.
Eivor, what a pleasant surprise. Would you drink with me?
Hunwald.
Come, sit. Stay with me a while and contemplate the view.
Be easy with your grief, Hunwald. If you're not careful, it's a poison you'll bear in your blood for the rest of your life.
No need to worry. For I have found the antidote for it.
Do not gorge on grief, nor give in to sadness, but let your aching love light the mead of your eyes and lead you to triumph.
That is quite lovely. My father would have liked you. He liked all those who could swing a sword and speak a verse with ease.
He had a large heart and a love for his people. I think I would have liked him too.
He and I used to wander up this way all the time. He would take me hunting, and I would catch the most wretched little things if I caught anything at all. I was a rubbish hunter. But he always said he was proud. Each and every time.
A toast.
Mm.
To your father, Lord Hunwald of Lincolnscire. He may have dwindled from this world in death, but in life he was as stalwart as this tree.
A wise old oak. Yes.
Skull.
Skull. And then my father says it's the right goat, but it's the wrong end. Oh, my Swanborough loves that one. She has a great sense of humour, my lady love. Father would have liked her.
Right, your Dane lady love. She sounds lovely. Too lovely to be real.
You know what? We should visit her. We should go to Grimsby. Yes, there's no time to lose.
After you.
Nothing like drinking and riding to jostle your troubles away.
And the contents of your gut.
Now come and enjoy the splendor of my shire.
You Saxons and your tiny splendor. You've never seen mountains, have you? Or deep fjords like a giant's axe wound? Or towering falls that steam in the dead of winter? Snow sparkling like a blanket of jewels? That is splendor.
Well, if your homeland is so splendorful, why come to England at all?
You can't grow crops on a blanket of jewels. Thank you.
well struck, Eivor!
That's twice they've tried to kill you, Hunwald.
And twice failed.
We had luck. But if you're not more careful, they will succeed. Someone in Mercia wants you dead. And they'll kill anyone in the way to see it done.
Yes, including my dear Swanborough, my lady love. Come, let us hurry away.
I'm serious, Hunwald. Are you hearing me?
Plain and clear. Follow me.
Hunwald, are you sure this place is safe?
The safest spot in the Shire, yes. Here I am with a chance to be Elderman, but I have yet to prove myself worthy. To you, to the Shire, to her. I can do nothing without my darling lady. You've made me realize how much I've neglected her through this fatal stupor of mine.
This I must see for myself.
Hunwald, I thought for sure you'd be dead. Why didn't you send word?
It has been far too long, my little jewel. I'm so very sorry for that.
I'm fine, my love. I wilted without you, but still I grow. And who is this?
Ah, yes. I am proud to present Eivor of the Raven Clan.
Hello, Eivor. A pleasure to meet you.
And you, Swanborough. I wasn't sure what to make of Hunwald's stories, yet here you are.
Surprised to find a Dane by his side?
Not quite. I'm surprised to find a Saxon at yours. Hunwald seems to endear himself to all sorts.
Eivor agreed to help me find my father. But I'm afraid it hasn't gone as well as I'd hoped.
What's happened?
My father is dead. Died of a cruel disease, apparently. Then shunted off to a cellar for burial.
Oh, my love, I'm sorry.
And someone in your shire wants to make sure Hunwald follows his father to the grave.
Let them try. I'll cut their throats.
A shire moot will soon be held. Hunwald should stay here, out of sight, until he can attend.
What if I left it all behind, my love? Forget my father's seat. What if I stayed here with you? Just the two of us.
Hunwald, no. This Shire must be led with courage and heart. Follow in your father's footsteps and lead the Shire as he did.
Whatever strength you lack, you have in Swanborough. Heed her advice.
Yes. If anyone can lift my spirits in time for the Shire moot, it's you, my dear.
Come inside and rest your bumbling bones, love. Be well, Eivor, and thank you.
Keep watch over that one. Men have come for him more than once.
My blade will keep him safe.
I don't doubt it.
Welcome to my estate, old friend.
Thane Aelfgar, it's an impressive amount of land you oversee.
Quite right. I often get lost swimming to my island in this flowing sea of wheat.
You're flush with land and crops, to be sure. You're a brave man to flaunt your riches from this lonely hill.
It's not bravery, it's trust. I trust the respect I've earned keeps Saxon and Dane alike from temptation.
You said you had something to show me when we last spoke. What did you mean?
Yes, I did. Observe. This fine specimen belonged to our beloved elderman, Hunbeort, before his untimely passing. He left it here when we last hunted together. I now wish you to have it.
If this belonged to the Elderman, shouldn't it go to Hunwald next?
I suppose so. But I thought you a more fitting recipient. You'd know how to use it. Now, take it and come hither. I have a rousing hunt planned for the two of us. Leave aside talk of politics and shire moots. Let us enjoy the fruits of my land together.
We're hunting or fruit picking?
Both, if you like. Whatever you fancy. I'm generous with the yields of my estate, as you will see. To be plain, Eivor, a great bear has... Must do away with it, if only to prevent a future tragedy.
You brought me here to hunt a bear?
Yes, and I'm so pleased you agreed to come. I suspect you know better than most that I have what it takes to lead this shire. Though its line of kings is all but ended, the people of this land still teems with life, with promise. But today, the shire languishes. It needs the guidance of new blood.
Like me.
I'm sorry?
I'm the definition of new blood. It may be I should put my name in for Elderman.
Ah, there it is, that dark sense of humor. Blunt as a hammer, eh? Like the one carried by your thunder god. I don't recall the name.
Go on.
What I mean to say is, I enjoy the company of your people. Or people like you. What little I've seen of them. And I don't care what stuffy fools like Herifriv and Hunwald say. Yeah! You Danes are damn decent people. Not dense at all.
Kind of you to notice.
I remember when the Danes first arrived, not long ago. The locals were...
Are we hunting, Aelfgar? Or is it your hope that I'll braid your hair?
Hunting, definitely. The bear's lair should be nearby. Grim. How wonderful to see you here. What a pleasant surprise.
What surprise? I came as you requested.
Yes, and how is Grimsby? How are all the other Danes?
I can't speak for all Danes, but I am well, and itching for a hunt as you made plain in your message this morning.
Yes, that's right. Very good. Speaking of Danes, I'd like to introduce you to Eivor. Perhaps you know each other as one Dane to another.
It is good to meet you, Grim.
Hail, Eivor. Did he lure you here as well with the promise of a hunt?
He...
Yes, hunting a bear. That's the point of all this. We're hunting, I promise.
There's a cave just up the hill there. Seems a likely place for a lair.
If the beast is as large as Aelfgar claims, it'll take all three of us to bring it down.
I'm game. Let's get a new fur cloak, shall we? There's all manner of beasts in this forest. If we don't find the bear, we'll find something worth our supper.
I have a divine rule over the land on my estate. God shall provide. Have no worry.
Huh? This is the threshold of the beast's home. There's no doubting that. That's not a bear. Picked up our trail. Hold on. Wolves!
Wolves everywhere! And not a bear in sight! Ugh!
There's something you'll want to see here. Is that? That smoke! My god! My estate is burning like a twig!
Soon to be a sea of fire.
Eivor! You're skilled enough, and I can't tell you how to handle this, but please! My god, help me with this!
I'm in this fight with you. A clutch of puny Mercians don't frighten me.
My people are fleeing. They must get to safety.
Someone waited until you were away to set your world
aflame.
I'll send them straight to hell, the marauding menaces!
The crops! The fields! They're burning the food!
Food's no good if there's nowhere to eat it. The houses burn, Eivor. Dogs!
The men who would see you burn are dead. Let's get these fires out.
Agreed.
What a mess. A sea of ashes. I thank you, Eivor, for doing what you could.
You're a man of many riches, Aelfgar. You can rebuild.
To be sure, but I do not look forward to the toilet. Sweet Lord in heaven!
The bear is returned!
The Shire moot will start soon. I should return to Lincoln to see that it goes well.
Picked up our trail. Hold on.
Archer, is everything ready?
The Shire moot will soon begin. Will you join us, Eivor? We'd be comforted by your presence.
Yes, I'm curious to see this Shire moot for myself. I'll follow. When will the boat begin, Abbas?
12 able lords of Lincolnscire have already cast their stones. But they have reached a tie. 4 votes for each man. It now falls to you to break this impasse.
Me? By whose order?
You have earned the trust of our 3 candidates, it seems. Even our bishop has found a certain fondness for your hardy spirit.
Aelfgar and Hunwald were attacked recently, and your bishop remains fearful. It's clear someone wants this stopped.
They tried, yes. But they did not succeed. Praise be to God.
I kept them safe, not your God.
I pray that God guides your vote today, and not the devil, as I fear.
How are you, Lord?
Have I heard aright that you have come to break us from our deadlock?
I have, Lord. Have you any advice before I vote?
Lord Hundbeor was a bold and honest man. If somewhat reckless. I see the same qualities in his son. Therefore, Hunwald is my man.
King Ceolwulf's attendant, aren't you?
Aye. The king sends his love and support. Whatever happens here today shall have his full blessing.
He's learning fast. Good man.
A vote for Hun...
Good evening, Aelfgar.
Eivor, I hope it's not untoward of me to solicit your support, but I do need it. The vote is closer than a cat's whisker.
It's a difficult choice, Aelfgar. Know that I won't make it lightly.
Good, good. But let me say unreservedly that I am the man who will lead Lincolnscire into progress and victory.
I don't doubt your convictions, Lord.
A vote for Hunwald will return the house of the ferocious swan.
Grim, good to see you again.
Hearty hello, Drengr. Seems Britain is getting quite used to the idea of Danes stalking her shores.
Where do you fall in this contest, Grim? Aelfgar is a friend of yours, is he not?
He is. And a good man as well. But I cast my stone for the bishop.
The bishop? That's an odd strategy.
These Christians are easy to nudge about. So desperate they are to avoid a good fight, they'll agree to most anything a Dane says.
A vote for Hunwald will return the House of the Ferocious Swan to its former glory.
How fare you, Lord?
My prayers are fervent and my will is strong, Eivor. If I am Elderman, I will bring joy to this Shire.
There's more to good leadership than merrymaking. You must be strong and stern and willing to take risks.
Of course, of course. Strength and wisdom and fortitude and all that. I shall rise above the peat moss of mediocrity. Have no fear.
That's good to hear. Three men, 3 possible futures. Which of these sad puppets will dance best when you call upon them? It's not for myself I must cast this stone, but for my clan. Who will serve us best in a time of true need? You can never be certain where you stand in another's heart. Choose only for yourself. All three have strengths and weaknesses. Though tinged with arrogance, Aelfgar is competent and wealthy. He'd be a good Elderman, but a faithful ally? Hunwald is not the most cunning or clever, but he has heart and spirit. Both go a long way in times of need. Lead your shire with pride, ferocious one.
It is decreed by this lawful shire moot that the Elderman of Lincolnscire shall be son of our dear and departed Lord Hunbjor, Lord Hunwald of Lincolnscire.
I don't know what to say. I thank you deeply, madly, humbly. What more can I say? I don't know. I miss my father. I'd sooner see him standing here than... Well, I will do my best for each and every one of you.
Let us all raise our cups. A toast to our new Elderman. As all well know, this Shire Moot's decision is not final, but advisory. It now falls to our newly anointed King Teowulf to ratify our choice. To this end, we need not worry. Teowulf is a friend to Saxon and Dane alike, and he is sure to approve the results. Our good and noble friend, Arvelswith.
The septic rot has overtaken this shire. A sickness for which there is only one cure.
Your Grace! What is this?
Nobles of Lincolnscire, stand fast!
For the glory of the ancients, leave none alive!
Steal yourself.
Picked up our trail. Hold on.
Comes a new Elderman.
This one's gone. Find those who still draw breath. Polish your ass, Hunwald. The Alderman's seat is yours. As your war council, I suggest you waste no time in catching this grief-totter. He won't be far.
We should first bury our dead, no?
That choice is yours to make, Alderman.
Yes. Yes, of course. We'll bury our dead, then raise a feared.
I am at a loss for words. A trusted man of the cloth. I will pray for these martyrs, and tend to the remaining wounded until the last man walks free.
Be well, Archer.
And you, Eivor. May God or the gods protect you.
A bold attack, and in broad daylight.
What news, Hunwald?
We've learned that Herivrith rode for the fort at Anicastri following the massacre. I have assembled a fyrd there. Quite a large one, in fact. They eagerly await your orders, Eivor.
You mean your orders, Alderman?
Ah, yes, that's right. My orders. Which are what, exactly?
Who can say? Ride with me to your camp, and we'll find out together.
Herivrith was a friend of my father's and always so dear to me. I don't understand what possessed him.
He invoked the name of an ancient order before his men attacked. I know exactly what possessed him.
Do you?
Before long.
How has Atcha taken all this? She and Herivrith were so close.
She must feel as though the devil himself attacked her monastery. The poor lady.
We spoke briefly. Her spirits were low, but her work carried on. I think she'll be fine.
Manipulated by a man who should be God's gladdener.
The turf this time, eh? Don't want to freeze to death here.
Heavens, do not wander off.
Hey! Here's the camp, do you see? The fyrd will soon be ready for action.
Give them mead and let them rest.
Our warsmith has arrived. The fyrds are ready to fight.
Chieftain Eivor, can we win this fight with the men you see assembled here?
If they fight with the bravery of double their number, we may.
And is there room in your Valhalla for a ferocious swan?
Of course. Let fly your glorious banner.
Are we ready then?
We attack now. Ready the fyrd.
Our first task will be to breach the outer wall. Then we deal with the troops inside.
Give them...
Come! We'll...
The best way to breach is with a battering ram. I should help it along.
Watch out! Arrow! Arrows incoming!
Ah!
Come on!
Watch out! Arrow! Arrows incoming! Your life for that!
Picked up our trail. Hold on.
We need to find a way past that palisade. An explosion could do it. Or I can try hitting it with a sprinkle.
Picked up our trail. Hold on. Picked up our trail. Hold on.
I got him! My thanks, Aelfgar!
That man with the bleed is done!
Picked up our trail. Hold on.
Aerofleet has gone mad!
You, point me to the bishop. No one else need die today.
He's in the chapel there, hiding away. Scabrous coward.
Let no one leave that church without facing judgment.
Picked up our trail. Hold on.
Must be blocked from the other side.
Picked up our trail. Hold on.
Kill this pagan! Pick the coward off! I'll keep the rough busy!
I died the day I hid behind these robes, this cross. To bring the light of my order to a wider view, I did baste myself. Clawed my way to the top of this common religion, full of common men. I should have lived as the ancients did.
That's the folly of mankind, Hedavrid. We wallow in our failures like happy pigs in a sty of shit. You should have learned to enjoy it.
Eivor. Is the bishop dead?
He bled too little and talked too much. Now he's gone.
I won't miss him. But Atcha will need some time to grieve.
You fought well, ferocious swan. Notched a few scars in your baby fat today.
Yes, but they will heal. And stronger than before.
Lincolnscire is yours to lead, Elderman. The hardest fight begins now.
The din of battle still rings in my ears. I think I now know what it means to be a leader.
Good.
I would ask a favor, if I could.
Name it.
As Elderman, my life may be a dangerous one. For a time, anyway. Would you allow my Swanborough to take refuge in your settlement? At least until I feel all danger has passed.
We'd be happy to have her.
Thank you, my sturdy Norse berserker. The mead halls of my shire will be lonely without you stomping about.
Our people are bonded now. We must look out for one another.
Blast it! I am a horror with goodbyes.
It'll do for now.
Now it seems the wind calls me back to Randvi. Let's tell her the good news.
Lincolnscire is a friend to us.
Wonderful news. And who is our ally there?
The boy Hunwald is the new Elderman of Lincolnscire, and he has sworn allegiance to us.
The Loud One, an Elderman? Well, should he ever wish to call for aid, he need only shout.